Hello everybody, my name is Teneille and I am a tutor on Cambly. Today we will be learning about homophones. Homophones are words that sound the same but have different meanings. Homophones, homo means same, phones means sound. So it's a common scenario, it happens to everybody everywhere. You're writing a note and you're about to write the word peak. But wait, is it sneak peek or sneak peek? Now think about the word stationery and stationery. Which one means writing paper? So these sets of words are called homophones and they can cause a lot of trouble for spellers. Okay, so what are homophones? Homophones are two or more words that sound alike, but are spelled differently and have different meanings. Deer and dear. Deer is an animal, and dear is an affectionate way of addressing someone. Let's look at bold and bold. Bold is construction. And bold is give or send someone a bill asking for money. Let's look at so and so. So is to plant seeds. And so is to stitch using needle and thread. Homophones occur in English because there are multiple ways of spelling the same sound. For example, the sound N can be spelt with the letter N or with a combination of letters K and N, resulting in night and night. The sound A can be spelled A consonant E or A-Y, resulting in days or days. So now I'm going to take you through some of the most often confused homophones. We're going to start with your and your. So your is a contraction of you and are. And your is possessive, so belonging to. So you could say, you're amazing. Or you could say, you're doing really well in today's English lesson. Using your, you can say, I appreciate your help. I think your lesson is going really well today. Our next set of most often confused homophones is there, and there. So there is a possessive belonging to them. And there is an adverb, a location. And there is a contraction of they and are. So we could say, their house is incredibly beautiful. I go there for English lessons. And he gave me flowers. They're so beautiful. Okay, now let's look at two. Two is a function word. Two means also, and two is a number. So, I want to go to the mall. I went to the mall too. And the two of us went to the mall. Our last set of our most often confused homophones is by, and by. So by, close to, by, to purchase, and by is short for goodbye. So he sat by her as they waited. I love to buy books. and they said bye shortly after they arrived. Okay, so just a quick recap. Homophones are words that sound the same but spelt differently. I know there are a lot of homophones, but I promise you, with time and practice, you will hack it. I'm going to share a few riddles with you that will help you remember and practice a few homophones. What did the dog say to the insect that bit him? Flee, flee. And what do you call a rough path? A coarse course. And what do you call a discounted boat ride? A sail, sail. And what do you call two pairs? A pair, pair. And our last one, what do you call an untied string? Not a knot. That's it for today. Happy learning, everybody. For those of you who are unfamiliar with Cambly, Cambly gives you instant access to friendly native English speakers like me. You can access Cambly from anywhere at any time from your computer or your phone. Schedule your next lesson with me by clicking the link below. And thank you so much for watching. Bye.